It's Sunday at Trendy Star. Hi, it's me. It's Ginny. And as you may have guessed, well, you may not have, probably. Basically, I was looking around my house, and the previous owner, well, actually, she still owns the house, but her stuff is still there, and she has, like, a ton of hats. I've never wore hats, so I had, like, one hat with the comic book guy from The Simpsons. You know, it said right here, I have issues or something like that. So, basically, I thought, well, I'm going to play with hats. And I declare this Hat Week on Trendy Star. Yeah, so everybody's going to wear a silly hat. More than likely not. I'm probably the only one that's going to do this. I just pulled this, you know, just like came up with this idea, like, earlier today. You know, they're probably seeing this and like, I don't want to wear silly hats, silly girl. Anywho, on to today's topic, or this week's topic. So it was my week to pick, and I chose two. First one is by Keegan 369-2002, and Keegan puts, how did you make the jump from realizing your trans status to actually putting it into practice? And basically, I like that one because I always knew I was transsexual since probably I was 10. It was like in 86. Yeah, I'm that old. And I will give you money not to figure out how old I am by me giving you that piece of information. I need to edit that. Anywho, I read like my mom's Ladies Home Journal or Red Book or something like that. And it said, it was about these two siblings in France, and they transitioned one after the other from male to female. And it was right then and there I knew that it was possible that, you know, I wasn't always going to be male. I could do something about it. And yeah, anywho, though, you'd figure like, okay, wow, she was on her way, but I wasn't because I had a lot of insecurities, which I've talked about before, and, ooh, puppy, which a lot of, and insecurities, so I was really afraid to start, really, just so afraid, and what happened was, I don't know, I just wasn't a happy person after a while. I couldn't find any joy anymore, and I was doing a lot of bad things back then. I don't do that anymore. Drugs are bad. But anywho, basically though, everything lost its edge. I started being very angry and very bitter because I was stuck in this body, and I would see like, you know, cisgendered women, you know, walking, and I was like jealous of them. You know, I worked in the mall, and you know, I would see them all together, and they're doing like things that, you know, that they take for granted that, oh my god, I would kill to do. And I wound up killing myself, and like literally, like they had to resuscitate my knee. I did pills. I don't want to say what pills or the doses because I don't want anybody to try it. It was a bad thing. I was very lucky, and when I got out, a therapist helped me with realizing that, what do I have to lose? You know, I was already throwing my life away, so I might as well try this, you know? And so basically, I've seen counseling, and within, I think, three months, I started hormones. And that was on June 2nd. 2008, and I can even tell you the time. It was 2:00 in the afternoon, Eastern time. Yeah. How sad is that? I know the exact hour and the exact day. And, I moved here to be full-time. I'm in the process of getting the scruff right here, getting rid of that. I started doing electrolysis in July, but had to quit because I lost my job, which really, really stunk. And, I moved here to North Carolina on, January 8th of 2009 to start going full time. And I'm very happy about that. And that leads into the second topic. And that is by Megan of Megan's Life over here on YouTube. I think Keegan's on you. Yeah, Keegan's on YouTube too. But Megan says, let me see here. Do you have a transition timeline? Would you recommend it? And yes, I do. I started one this year because I had so many setbacks and everything was stalled. And I had that problem. I procrastinate, so I do a little timeline. The first was to start doing the hair removal and start around June, getting my name changed. Changed my license to Jennifer, and hopefully by the end of this year, I'll have my Orchie and I can start changing my birth certificate. Since I live in Michigan, all you need is an Orchie, thank God, because I don't think I'll be able to afford a SRS for a while, unless y'all want to pay. No, it's okay. Anywho. Yeah, that was that. And, well, I'm out of hats, so. Oh, would I recommend it? Yes, I do. It gives you a perspective of how far you have to go and how far you've gone. And you should stick to it, really, as much as you can. Granted, things are going to get in your way, you know. And if they do, don't let it get you down. And if you're trying to thinking of transitioning and you're afraid, sweetie, your fear is a lot worse than the actual process. It was not nearly as bad. It hasn't been all roses, but it's been a lot more rewarding. And trust me, if somebody looking like me and can do this, anyone can. You need to be your real self. And, you know, don't hide, because it's not healthy, and I have friends that have told me, well, today I feel good in my cis, the gender that everybody sees me at now, and I did too for a while, and it was always fleeting, always, and those feelings always come back. Just no matter what, remember, you're beautiful, you're awesome, and you all have the right and can actually pursue a happy life and be comfortable in your own skin. Well, that's all for now. Bye. Mila and Jana will be on next week, and hopefully Mina will be here tomorrow. So, till then, hi, bye, love you. Drain, you rock.